Hi, in this video I will explain how you can display an organization chart in a visual analytics report. When displaying data, you may want to show some results based on the department or product category, for example. You would like maybe to navigate the sales results by manager and see how many people are reporting to a manager. I will explain you how it can be done using SAS Visual Analytics and a bit of JavaScript. I will first explain what data-driven content object is and how it can be used to create customized elements in Visual Analytics. There will be a warning related to the data used in the object, a little demo to demonstrate the application, and more importantly, how it was created. The data-driven content object is a standard SAS Visual Analytics object like the graph or the table objects. But you can use them to implement functionalities which may not be available out of the box in Visual Analytics. You can, for example, use D3JS, React, or any other JavaScript frameworks to build visuals or to retrieve data from the web or any other data provider, for example. Technically, the data-driven content object has access to the same data as any other object in the report. You get automatic interactions with other objects and you can use the DDC to filter other objects, for example. From a development perspective, the data-driven content object is an HTML page with a bit of JavaScript to manipulate the data coming from the report and send the data back to it. SAS provides some utility functions on GitHub to ease the development of such a web page. I think it's important to indicate that while data-driven content objects are great to improve the visuals, you as a developer should be careful with the data you are displaying, especially when it comes to aggregated values. When you define the data roles in the data-driven content object, you are technically passing aggregated data to the object. As a result, if you want to display data at a different level of aggregation, you need to recalculate it in the JavaScript code. While summing frequencies or sums is perfectly fine, you can't calculate an average based on the children averages. Just to make it clear, if you are summing the average weights for the girls, you get a total of 430.75. And if you calculate the average, you get 86.15. In that case, you should use a weighted average to get the correct result. How do you calculate this? 5.61 is the result of 50.5 divided by 9 and multiplied by 1. 17.94 is the result of 80.75 divided by 9 and multiplied by 2, and so on. If you sum up these values, you get a total of 90.1, which is the correct result. This is just an example, but the same applies to more elaborated aggregation methods, which are also available in Visual Analytics. Let's start with a demo. I will open up my report. You see here that I have a report with two objects, the data-driven content object and the list table. If I click on the data-driven content object, it's filtering automatically the data in the list object. I can drill, select, drill further, get the information, and so on. If I'm here at the superhero level, you will see that I can filter it. I can go back to North, for example, select another state, and in that state, go further. So the breadcrumb can also be used to navigate in the data, as well as the arrows at the bottom at the top of the node element. How is it done within Visual Analytics? If I select the data-driven content object, I will just check the options, and you see here that I'm pointing to a localhost 3000. This is a local web server that I'm running for testing purpose, and this is also the reason why you see that it is not secure, because I have used a self-signed certificate. Then I assign some roles, and the roles, the order of the variables is important because this is defining the order and the different levels. And then I have the action, and the action in this case is just to filter the list table down below. Maybe something that is more interesting is to look at the code. So in this case, I've created an application using React, and more specifically React with TypeScript. You can use the normal version of React, but using the TypeScript version, you are enforcing the type check, which makes it easier to evaluate the quality of your code and to avoid passing incorrect data between the objects in your web application. So in this case, I will start with a few components. So this one was the breadcrumb, which is displayed. It creates the breadcrumb information using breadcrumbs from Material UI, as you can see over here. It defines the path based on the different levels, and you can use it to click on any level, then to navigate back and forth. You have also the nodes, and this is a component that I've also created using the cart component from Material UI. It's using the card and also badges. The badges are for the values that you see over here with the number of children. The card displays the icon at the top and the bottom with expand less icon and expand more icon, which is exactly what you see for the use for the navigation. And inside it, we are just displaying a text. This component receives data and displays the data from the application. We have also interfaces. So the interfaces are the ones that are defined to do the type checking within TypeScript. You have one for the levels, you have one for the nodes. You see that the nodes in this case, we have an interface iNode, and it's used also for the children. You have VA data, which represents the data coming from the visual index report. We have VA data event, VA message, and the VA message is what we are sending back to the report. It has a specific structure with the result name, the message, or the selection. If you send a message, it's displayed to the user. If you send a selection, it's filtering the other objects. And then you have the VA selection, which is a row and which represents a number. And in this case, this is the position of the row in the array that we received from VA. We have also a few functions. The first function I will talk about is the send message to VA. This is the one that is responsible for sending information to the VA report, whether it's a text that is displayed to the end user, or whether it's the selection that is passed from the data-driven content object. You have defined levels, which is used to retrieve the information about the different levels in your architecture. It's going through the data columns element and looping and generating the information. And as you can see here, it's checking for the type. If it is string, this is perfectly fine. It adds the level. If it's not a string, then we are sending a message back to the end user telling him that only categorical variables are supported in the DDC object. This is just a limitation of the code we have here. It's not a limitation from VA, so you can also integrate the data, but it's in this case, it's not used. Then you have the build tree. So the data we are receiving from the VA report are structured in an array. So all the data are row by row, like in a list table, but in this usage, we need to create a structure. To create that structure, I've created a flattened tree, which means that all the data are at the same level and not building the hierarchy inside the different objects. So each level, each object has only two levels. So the parent node information and the children's that are depending on it. If the children, for example, has some children, so grandchildren from the parent node, it's a new object that is added as a new row in the tree, and this is why we call it a flattened tree. We need therefore to loop through the data that we receive and take action based on this, on the data, and if there is children, if there is no children, and these kind of things. Then you have the build selection. This is the one that is responsible to create the selection when a user clicks on a node. So in that case, you need to retrieve the row ID from the data and pass the data back to the report object. And this is the one that is, this function is responsible to build the array that is passed back to the VA report. So all of these small components, they are tied together into the app.tsx. This is where we are using the use state from React. Using use state, we are triggering refresh of the interface. So you have an action that is done when we receive data from VA. And in that case, we set the VA data and we build the tree data. Then what we do is we listen to a message that is received from VA. And as soon as we do that, we are processing. Another thing that we do is define the parent node and the selected node as soon as the data is populated. So the tree is created, and then we are selecting the top level, the parent node, the one with the zero level, which is then selected and filters the data in the list table in this case. Then if there is a change in the parent state, so if you are clicking on a node, expanding it, it will become automatically the parent and will be displayed as such. And then you need to trigger some other actions like setting the children, setting the selected node, and display the divider label. Displaying the divider label is this information that you see over here that comes from the variable name. We have then the selection that is done properly. So we are, when we change the selected node, we are then building the selection, and the selection is then passed back using the set message function. As you can see in this case, we could have a multiple selection, but it's not really implemented in the user interface, but the functionality is there with the use effect. Then you have the navigation handler, which is the function that is called when you click on a node or when you navigate from one node to the other. The final step is to bring all of this together, and we are building the getting the breadcrumb, displaying a grid of data. And in that grid of data, we are displaying the different nodes that we have created. You have a divider, and then you display all the nodes that are the children nodes. This is the application. It's running here on a local server, which is fine for development. To do this, you need to configure cores and CSRF properly, as documented within this official SAS documentation. And if you decide then to build the application and deploy it, you can do it using the build script from React. It will create a build folder that can be then deployed on your via environment. That's it for the demo. You can find more information on this topic in SAS documentation. Multiple blogs and videos are also available on the topic and will help you to better understand how the data-driven content object can be used to enrich the visual experience in SAS Visualytics. So thanks for watching, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.